everyone. Good morning. It's Saturday, October 14th, and I'm here at Barnegat Inlet. Today I'm going to be doing some tog fishing, but to start the morning off, I'm going to try for some striper. I'm probably going to go take the trek all the way to the end of the inlet, go on an SP minnow, and see what we can do. I've got green crabs, I've got sand crabs, so you know, after we're done trying for striper and we hit the tog, you know, we got plenty of bait to last us the day. The tide's high right now. You can see from the water that's pooling in past the rocks, but it's a beautiful morning. The jetty is pretty quiet. You can't beat that. So the sun's pretty much just peeking over the horizon right now. You can see that. But I forgot to mention too that tonight is the new moon, so probably why the tide is so interesting. I'll show you when I get to the end. I'm still walking. I'm gonna wait out here. I decided to stay down here just because these rocks are slippery and I don't have cork roots with me. So we're just gonna chill in the water down here and see what happens. Alright, I cast it around for a little bit. Striper's just not in the cards yet. So I'm gonna switch to tog and I'm gonna actually head back down the jetty towards the lighthouse. All right, so I'm back down the other side of the jetty and I'm gonna start with one nice sand crab. Kind of see what's down there. I'm just gonna hook it right through and then just keep it right kind of where the barb is. And I'm gonna drop it down, see what happens, see what is down there, and then hopefully we start catching some good fish. Kind of like bobber fishing, you wanna wait to get past the taps, which are usually the smaller fish, and then the pulls are the bigger fish, and that's when you set the hook. So I'm getting tap, 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 tap. Whole lot of taps. I can actually see them down there. My bait's not too deep. And I'm seeing these fish take my bait, but they are small. Oh! Let's try that. Let's just throw that down. They will clean your hook, so if you have bait left over on it, just throw it back down there. Use it. Saves you some. There we go. Alright. Little guy. It's definitely what was. Oh, and there he goes. It's tog fishing, you lose a lot of bait, and that's why you gotta get a lot of it, because they steal it and they know how to peck it off your hook. I'm actually gonna go one rock farther just because I want to keep the rig as vertical as possible to feel that bite a little better. There we go. Alright, it's a decent sized one. Got ourselves a decent sized tog. Well, I'd say that was like 12 inches most. Keeper size in New Jersey right now is one fish at 15 inches. You'd be surprised kind of how hard it is to get a tog. You really got to put in work to get that 15-inch fish. See, they got mean old teeth in there. This one's pretty sharp. All right, thanks for playing. Oh, that's a keeper. Pretty early in. It's a good like 17, 16 and a half. All right, you're coming home, dude. That's a good fish right there. All right, well, I had to run back to my car to get my cooler since I got that keeper. I didn't even bring it out with me. I wasn't even thinking. Fortunately, I had ice left over from yesterday's bait, so ill-prepared as always, but we figured it out. I still have all my bait left, so I want to get through as much as we can. I think I'm just going to stay close to the lighthouse, drop down some more lines, and see what else we can get. This guy felt a lot bigger than he actually is. So since the water was pretty clear and calm on this side of the inlet, I decided to drop the GoPro down underwater just to see kind of what was going on. And you'll see there's a lot of fish, and more will show up later too, but a lot of small ones, and they're pecking at those sand fleas. They can't quite get them all in their mouth. I drop down again, and this one fish kind of picks up the whole sand flea and starts to swim away, which is when I know to set the hook. And I start bringing him in, but he drops it, and I don't know if you could see, but he doesn't actually have the whole hook in his mouth, he more just has the sand flea. And yeah, I really love the shot, because you could just see how many are down there, and how much these sand fleas attract so many fish. Sea bass, that's pretty cool. All right, it's about 10 a.m. now. I've been here since about 6:45 a.m. so I've gotten at least a dozen tog at this point, and I've lost probably four or five rakes of the rocks. I still have a lot of bait left, so I'm going to try to get through as much of it as I can, and we'll see how many more fish I catch. Let's keep fishing. I have so many sand fleas left that I'm just going to start chumming, getting some out there to get the fish chewing a little more, but I do want to get home and fillet that fish because it has been sitting for a little bit in the ice. Even though it's on ice, I'd rather fillet that as fresh as possible. So time to use my last hook. So I forgot that I had these tog jigs in my tackle box, and I really didn't feel like tying another rig, so this works out perfect. I'm more of a rig person than jigs, but let's try this out. With these, they sit on the bottom and you'll feel the taps, but you really want to wait for when the tog pick it up and run. That's when you'll set the hook. It's a pretty good fish.
All right.
Nice fish. Back in. But that's the name of the game when it comes to tog, is just getting stuck. All right, I need to pop that off. This is a bigger sea bass. So I'm gonna do a blackened recipe with this tautog. I filleted it up, and to start, I show each of the seasonings on screen, and I'm just making sure to evenly distribute it across the fillet, making sure I get total coverage. I'm just gonna rub it in just to make sure I get it all over the fish. Now I'm gonna throw down some butter, let it cover the entire bottom of the pan. And then dropping those fillets in. Now I'll cook these for around about 3 minutes each side. And then I'll flip it over, cook the other side. And you'll see the charring from the seasoning. That's why it's called blackened. Next I'm gonna make a spicy garlic butter sauce to drizzle on top of the fish. I throw in a decent amount of butter, let it melt. Then I take just about a tablespoon of minced garlic. Throw that in there, let the aromas get going. Then I'm gonna squeeze half a lemon to get that juice going in there. This will give it a really nice tang. I'm gonna throw in that smoked paprika, some cayenne, and Old Bay. Mix everything together. Let it sit for a little bit on a low heat. Here's the finished product. Just drizzled that sauce over the fish. So the fish came out really good. It tastes spicy, it tastes zesty, and I really enjoyed it. It was a nice lunch. So thanks for watching. See you guys on the next one. And if you try this recipe, let me know.